And now we will learn how to set up the icon bar so that the rest of the course will be much, much easier. The icon bar is simply a set of shortcuts to the same windows that you can open from the main menu. In this video, we will learn how to delete the icons that QuickBooks put, add icons that we will use most of the time, and of course, we can edit the icon bar so that it will suit our needs. First, we will remove the icons that QuickBooks put. Now, in the recent versions of QuickBooks Windows for desktop, the icon bar is here on the left, and whichever window you click, it'll automatically open up as a shortcut instead of having to go all the way to the main menu. But I don't like the icon bar on the left. I don't feel it's as clear as it was in the older versions. So the first thing I'm going to do is click View and choose Top Icon Bar. Now all these shortcuts are across the top, and if we run out of room, we click here and we have all the extra icons because I squashed the window down a little. If you have different screen resolution and you can spread it out, you can open it up a bit. Now, the Customize Icon Bar window is the window that allows you to remove, edit, and customize the icon bar. You open it up from the main menu. You click View, then go down to Customize Icon Bar. Now you're in the Customize Icon Bar window. And if you look at this panel on the top left, you see that each of the items here correspond to each of the items in the icon bar because that's what they represent. Click on the top one and click Delete. Notice it disappeared. Notice Client Review is next, and when I click Delete, that one disappears. Notice the icon bars shift left. So Home is to the left of Statement Writer. If I delete the Statement Writer, now Home is the one all the way to the left, and so on. If you keep clicking Delete, they will all eventually go away. Be careful. You must click OK, because if you click Cancel, they come back. It won't save what you changed. View, Customize Icon Bar, Delete, Delete, Delete. Make sure you click OK, and then you have successfully removed all the icons that we don't need. And now we'll put up in the icon bar the transaction windows that we usually use. For example, we usually receive payment from the tenant. So we're going to click from the main menu, Customers, Receive Payment. And this is the window we open up when we get paid from the customer, or the tenant in this case. Since we're going to be using this all the time, we should make this first in the icon bar. The way to put up the active window in the icon bar is, at the moment the window is active, go to the top left and click View. You will see the name of the window will be down here, Add Receive Payments to the icon bar. Click on it, and then click OK, and you notice our first icon. We click Payment, and the Receive Payment window opens up. Same thing with an invoice. If we want to acknowledge that we've earned the rent and or give a document to the client to pay for the coming month, we set up an invoice. From the main menu, we click Customer, Create Invoice. At the moment the invoice window is the active window, we go to the top left and we click View, Add Create Invoice to the icon bar, and click OK. Now we have a shortcut to open invoice. And now that we have a shortcut to the two most common transactions that landlords need, we're now going to put up customized reports. These are reports that landlords need and help us find things we are looking for in QuickBooks. There will be a future video discussing report customization, and in that future video, we'll go more deeply with more customization features and options, and of course, it will be presented clearly from beginning to end. All we're going to do now is slightly adjust the reports to help set up the file. The first report we're going to put up is called the trial balance. It shows the accumulated totals of each account in the chart of accounts. From the main menu, we click Reports, go down to Accountant and Taxes, go directly across, and go down to Trial Balance. Click on Trial Balance, and the Trial Balance report opens. Of course, it shows numbers being zero because we haven't recorded any transactions yet. But the most important thing to notice is the date range that the trial balance opened to by default is January 1 of 2019 to January 31 of 2019. That's because the computer thinks that January of 2019 is last month. And the computer thinks that because today I am filming this video on February 3rd, 2019. Therefore, last month, from the point of view of the computer, is January of 2019, and that's how it opens, from the main menu. However, it is more helpful to our course if you click on the date range, scroll up, and tell QuickBooks we want to see the results of all transactions, regardless of date. We can make the window a little taller by clicking and dragging the border, and we will use this trial balance report to help find and fix mistakes. We will use this trial balance report to see the results after each of the transactions that we record in all of the future videos. So let's save it to the icon bar. From the main menu, click View, Add Trial Balance to the icon bar, and click OK. And now you can see if you close the window. Oh, wait. If you try to close the window, it's going to ask you, do you want to memorize the report? We want to click Do Not Display This, and we want to click No, because we just memorized it in a better way than QuickBooks is suggesting to us right now. Click No. Click Open here, and not only does it open, but it remembers we like the pull-down range to be all. If we go all the way back to the main menu and reopen it fresh the way we originally did, you can see that it will open, the one we opened from the main menu, will open by default with last month. So that's an example of modifying a report, and then after you modify it. The next report that we will save in the icon bar is called the journal. It's one of the most important reports in QuickBooks. It's the only report that will show every single transaction ever recorded into the file since you created the file. It's also the only report that can show you transactions in the order in which they were entered into the computer, because all the other reports in QuickBooks show you the transactions in date order. So we really do need this report. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Journal. Notice the computer still thinks it's February of 2019, so by default it opens this month to date. Click the top left pull down and choose all. We're telling the computer that we want to see the results of all transactions regardless of date. This will help us use the journal in the future to find and fix mistakes. Now, we want to customize the journal a little bit more. If you want to customize the journal more than just the date, you have to move the mouse to the top left where it says Customize Report. Notice in the Modify Report window, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 different tabs with 4 different ways to customize any QuickBooks report. Click the Display tab in the top left, and notice there's a panel in the bottom left of this tab that shows you all the columns that you are able to put on a report. Let's remove the ones we don't want. Click here where the check mark says Adjustment to remove the adjustment column, then scroll down until you see Debit and Credit. Click to remove the check marks from Debit and Credit and replace them with a check mark next to the word Amount. When you click OK, you can see that the debit and credit columns are gone and all you have is amount here, and the adjustment column has also... And the last change we will make is to add a column that shows the date and time that each transaction was actually entered into QuickBooks. You see, this column here, date, is actually the date of the transaction. It's not the date and time that the transaction was entered into QuickBooks. If we add that column, then it will be much easier to use this report to find and fix problems and mistakes. Again, from the top left, we click Customize Report, and the fourth choice down is Entered Last Modified. Click to place the check mark in the margin, then click OK, and now you can see Entered Last Modified has been added to the journal. Now that the journal looks the way we need it to look, let's add it to the icon bar. From the top left, click View, Add Journal to the icon bar. Then click OK, and now the journal will look the way we need it to look if we open it from the icon bar. Now let's just add a separator between the section of transactions and the section of reports. From the main menu, click View, Customize Icon Bar, and click right above where you would like the separator to appear, and then click Add Separator. If you do it twice, you see there are two little lines separating the transaction section of your icon bar from the reports. To keep the changes, click OK, and now you learned how to manage your icon bar.